Well, first of all, thank you everybody for joining in. Today we are hosting Great Grandmaster Rob Castro, where this is your chance to ask him questions and just get to know him a little bit, just to get his background, to even see what he's doing, what's he up to, where is Shaolin Kenpo going, okay? We want to know what his vision is. So, Great Grandmaster Rob, you've got the floor.
I do. Okay. Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining in. Thank you, John.
All right. So, you've got the floor, sir.
All righty. Questions? Anybody have anything? Well, let me start off. Let's see. Shaolin Kenpo, as far as where we want to take it, yes, internationally. It was a dream of my dad to further his art other than just having it on the West Coast. We have schools throughout the US, but we want to take it further. It's been a couple years now, a few years since my father has passed away. And unfortunately with COVID, in the mix there, it kind of set things back, but we're not going to let that stop us. We're going to move forward and get Shaolin Kenpo out there in whatever way we can do it, and hopefully this is one of the ways to get it out there.
So now I would like to get John Kraft to unmute himself so that this way, see if he's got any questions for Great Grandmaster Rob.
Well, I have a million questions.
John always has questions.
Yeah, I probably talk way too much. When I'm asking a question, I get more questions as I'm asking. So imagine being inside my head. And so a big thank you to Sonny, because we would not be here right now doing all of this if it wasn't for Sonny. So a big thank you to Sonny. Now on to Great Grandmaster Rob. I have some questions. And so in different conversations we've had, you mentioned that you're family friends of Ed Parker and his children, and that you guys were very close when you were young. And that I think that you might have said that you guys spent holidays together. And so the Parker family and the Castro family were very, very close. I do believe that your dad and Mr. Parker trained together underneath Professor Chow and were lifelong friends from Hawaii. And they stayed that way until the very end. So if you could address the Parker-Castro connection.
Okay. Yes, Ed Parker and my dad were very good friends. They knew each other in the Coast Guard, is actually how they met. And my father at the time did not know that Ed Parker was involved in martial arts, involved in training with Professor Chow, until one day when my dad did go to Professor Chow's school and saw a picture up on the wall and had seen that it was Ed Parker. So that's when my dad, he started training there at with Professor Chow, and through the years of being involved in the Coast Guard and being friends together, they kept that connection going. Eventually leaving Hawaii, Ed Parker moved down to Southern California, took his art, Kenpo Karate, to Southern California. My father took his art to Northern California, and they continued to spread their art in that sense. Through that friendship of years with in the Coast Guard, so on and so forth, our families, through being involved in the martial arts, there was that connection. Yes, their family, six children, And our family, we had seven. And we did. There were a lot of family gatherings through the tournaments scene as well, with Mr. Parker having the international challenge or the international championships down there in Long Beach. And then later on, my father having the California Karate Championships in San Francisco. So we would see each other through those events as well, spending time after the tournaments. So growing up, and our the age groups, both families were pretty similar. Me being at, I believe, Beth or Darlene, I believe, Mr. Parker's oldest daughter, we were the same age. And through the years, you know, they had, you know, younger siblings, and along with myself. So there was, again, we were very close in age. And every time we had a chance, when my father and for our family and the Ed Parker family would get together, we could, whether they were visiting, whether we were visiting down in Southern California or they were visiting us up in Northern California, we had some really, really, really close and great times together. Yes.
Cool. Very cool. So in next March in Boston, at Grandmaster Paul Cervisi's extravaganza, there's going to be a lot of senior grandmasters, including yourself, and just a lot of really knowledgeable people in the martial arts are going to be there. It's going to be fantastic. Master Sonny will be there. I will be there. William Kampos, who's a Shaolin Kenpo practitioner there in California, texted me the other day and said he'd like details because he may be bringing his team to compete at their tournament. So he's looking forward to it. Ed Parker Jr. is going to be there, and I'm hoping that I get to hear the two of you interact with each other, because I'm really anxious to see that and to hear what you guys have to say to each other. How long has it been since you've seen one another?
I'm trying to think. It's been a few years. Actually, I believe it was at there was a event at the museum, Martial Arts Museum, down in Southern California that we were attending, and I believe Edmund was there, and we got to talk then. So it's been a few years.
You said that he is now an artist. Mainly,
he has always been an art. I mean, his drawings, his everything that he's done in that sense, as far as his that the art of that is unbelievable. He has got some unbelievable stuff that it really that he's come up with. He's also expanded on, I believe, his father's art or his own art, martial arts that he's promoting and putting out there as well. So,
okay.
Really interesting to be able to see him again and talk to him and, you know, reminisce about old times as young kids and stuff like that. So it'll be fun.
Well, we learn to appreciate that as we grow older, things we take for granted, people that we see all the time, and then when we get older, we learn to appreciate those people more.
Yes.
So I have another question. Moving on to Bruce Lee.
Who's that? No, I'm just kidding.
And I know that I'm sure we've got other questions from other people, but the best thing about doing these kind of Zoom podcast meetings, whatever you want to call it, is that there's always the next one. Because the last thing we want to do is take up too much of your time, sir. So I'm actually quite excited because we have your sister, Grandmaster July, who's going to be on the next one, as well as you. I mean, you can definitely join in at the same time. And I'm sure between the two of you, you'll have stories to talk about. But the best part is you're going to hear it from your side and her side. And you know how they say that there's always his story, her story, and then, of course, in the middle, the truth. But I'm sure between the two of you, it'll be exciting to hear what you guys are, I guess, up and coming. Thank you very much, everybody. I really appreciate you guys. Love you all. And make sure, have a blessed, happy holidays. As you can see, I've got my holiday stockings on. So again, happy holidays. All right.
Happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Year, thank you.
Thank you.